So, list of stuff that I do. So, I'm a qualified actuary from London. I was working at Barclays Capital for a bit. I was also with the Central Bank of Malaysia, working as an actuary analyst for them. Also doing some amount of consultation work. And then, recently, I started a few different companies because I realized that the tendency to execute in the market, meaning that people get a lot of ideas, but they don't go out and execute it. So I thought that why don't I take all the ideas that's kind of bad there, and then I just execute it. So the last 1 year I've been like figuring out what are the ideas that's kind of not being done in the market, not being executed in the market, and I've been executing it. So these are the list of things I do, but there are several things that I've been working on for the last 2 months basically. And I just want to introduce to you guys. Number one is this. So the chip that you guys are looking at here, this thing, is called Hive, Hive. Okay, we created a new Bluetooth 4.0 technology to actually track anything you want to track. We replace all battery, waterproof and stuff like that, first in the market with that particular price. So how many of you know Tile? Right? So this is Xiaomi of Tile. So what we did was we were able to decrease the cost by 95% to actually produce this. Water resistant with replace all battery. So Tile, their technology, they cannot do that. So this is the first thing that we've been working on. We're going to go to Kickstarter in another 2 months. We are in the process of actually making the video to actually advertise the whole thing. And we're also in the process of creating the Ruby on Rails site and also the app to actually make this work. Okay, the technology is already done. We already ordered a quantity of 20,000 to sell to the first beta testers. Next one is this, Backers. So Backers is somewhat similar to most healthy food delivery services in the market, but it's a difference here. They have been supported by dietitians. They're not just like cooking Maggi goreng and stuff like that. The stuff that they do actually comes from a gourmet kitchen, which means that you're getting food that's really, really awesome and delicious. But the kicker is this. If you don't see results by actually eating this particular food, we actually give you back your money, everything. So we commit to the results, and then you buy from us. And if you don't end up getting the results, and it's because the food didn't work, we'll actually give you back the money. So that's the caveat here. Okay, the second product that we're working on. Number three is this. So a while back, I noticed that there is no good event organizers in the nightclub market and also clubbing market, right? So we brought clubbing event to the market. We call ourselves 5XSide, tongue-in-cheek reference to sexside. And we've been organizing a lot of parties lately. Most of it nowadays has been we go more towards private party because we get more money that way. And the events that you guys are looking at, we've been doing in Zouk, Gravity, and moving forward, we'll be one of the only people in the market who'll be able to organize events with Zouk. And we concentrate a lot with the student market. Number four, something else I've been working on for the past year, but then we finally figured out how we're going to pivot with it. It's called Lifehack Malaysia. Initially, when we started it, we wanted to help people to become more productive, people to do whatever they do better. But what happened was we realized that the market is not ready for it. But so recently we pumped in another 150K into the project to actually make it into a marketplace for things that people normally get from Kickstarter, but we sell it in Malaysia. So it's drop shipping for Kickstarter projects. So what we do is we see any cool projects or products in Kickstarter, we put the money first, and then we buy in bulk, and then we sell it here back to this market. So the site is now up, so you guys can actually go and check it out. Okay? And now I'm going to go to the content. So those are the things that I do. So you guys can see that I've been in the hardware market. You guys can see I'm in the F&B market. You guys see I'm in the event market and all that. So I have enough insights into most of these markets. Okay, because every time we go into a new market, we actually do the whole market study and stuff like that. So if any of your idea related to all these markets, we can help you guys. Okay? Okay, so that's the boring part. So let's get to the content. Okay? I'm going to tell you guys a story. So there's this guy who went around the world, you know. He went every single place in the world, learned every single thing that he can learn. He mastered every single art, everything that is to know. Okay? But the thing is, right, he still felt like he cannot work at the pace that he wants to, and also he feels like something is lacking. He has learned everything, you know, meaning that anything you tell him, like, oh, atom, he can talk about everything. Oh, quantum physics, he can talk about it, right? But he still felt like something is lacking, something huge is missing. Okay? So he went and approached this particular monk who stays in a very deserted place like this, and then he actually just stays by himself. But he's known as the world's most knowledgeable person, and he can answer everything, right? And he was thinking that, I know everything, but I cannot be performing at that level. And when he went to ask the monk, how do you do this? The monk took out a teapot, and then he started pouring tea. He just started pouring tea. And then he poured so much that it's all pouring. It's just like pouring out. And what happened was basically, why, yeah? Sorry? Talk louder. Correct. So basically what's happening now is that the guy has been capturing a lot of knowledge to the point it's actually all pouring, right? Meaning that he's not starting with zero every time. He's not absorbing anymore. So the thing that I want to stress even before I start is this. I always stress this, that I know you guys are smarter than me. You guys can do more stuff than me and all that. But let's start with zero. Even like whatever I said before this, let's assume that's not there anymore. All of us are zero at this moment. Okay? And I want to teach you guys on how to ideate. This is a process that we developed a while back. All the companies I currently work with, I actually use this process. And it's been refined about 4 or 5 times now. And it works all the time. Okay? So one of the things that I always hear is this. People always say that I'm buying this, buying that, and stuff like that. That makes us believe that we were made to consume. Now ask yourself this question. When was the last time you consumed something? It should be like today morning or now, right? So there's always this tendency for us to consume more than creating. That's the way that the world is designed, so that we have more demand than supply, just in case that particular thing, the whole equilibrium needs to happen. It's always like that, right? But this process that I want to explain is this. When you consume something, right, when you consume something here, okay, you only see this bit, you know, because you only get to experience what the person intended, right? Okay, so whenever you create something, right, you get to see how to create something bigger. You also get to see what's the thing that you're lacking, what we can do with it. So there's always this part in every single product that we consume that we're missing. There's always this part that we, by default, will miss. We cannot see it, right? If I ask you, how do they produce Coke? Not cocaine, but Coca-Cola, right? So last time the guy was like, oh, that's so easy, but I can teach you Breaking Bad. Okay, so you'll only see like what you get and how it tastes like, but you never see what goes into it. In fact, no one in the world actually kind of know, right? So that's the part that you're always missing. And today that I want to actually bring you to this particular side of creating stuff. So we want to see the whole iceberg at the bottom. So don't worry about, is it available? Have I consumed it? Have I seen it before? Let's just think about creating. Okay? So I want to set some ground rules. Number one, I want you guys to act like babies, which means that babies, right, they don't judge each other. I've never seen a baby that goes like, well, that's a stupid idea. Never happened before, right? Babies will never do this because they are very open about things, number one. Babies will never try and fail. The baby will never go like, I shouldn't touch the fire because the fire will burn me, right? The baby will never say that. The baby will try to touch it, right? Because by default, the baby is very, very prone to trial and error. The baby don't have any prior assumptions, and the baby also don't judge others. So we're going to go to that particular state. Okay? Number one, don't be a jerk. If somebody tells you something stupid, you can just like let it slide. Okay? Don't be like, oh, that's so stupid, man, get the fuck out. No, don't do that. Okay? And then don't try to act like you are a dominating person, I know everything kind of stuff. Don't do that as well. Okay? Don't go like, oh, I've created Operation Model for Telangana National, let me lead you guys. Don't do that. Okay? This guy's like, shit, my trick is out. Okay, and I want you guys to consistently ask this question, are you crazy enough? Yeah. Most of the time. Did somebody just say yeah? Okay, good. Okay, so we have one crazy person here. Okay, so the idea behind this is this. Whenever you throw an idea, right, I always do this self-check. If it's not crazy enough, meaning that people are like, ah, that one's not bad, I normally will be like, how to make this crazy? That's the question I ask myself. Meaning that anything that you guys are going to throw out later on, make it crazy. Okay, if you guys were thinking about, let's say, creating a device that can actually drive you guys from here to, let's say, Bangsa, now I want you guys to think about teleporting. That kind of crazy, meaning just crazy. There's a reason for it. If you guys don't do that, this activity won't work. Okay? And the last one is this. This is the question I always ask people. What's the most important technology for brainstorming? Anybody? Google? Quite good, but that's not the most important technology. What else?
Brain.
The brain. Smart. Okay, so every single person here has already been pre-equipped with your brain, right? Anybody left your brain at home? Okay, good. Okay, so he's like, hey, okay, didn't forget today. You need the Hive thing, bro, for your brain. Okay, so the idea here is basically all of you guys have already been pre-equipped with your brain.
meaning that you don't need anything else. Whenever you're brainstorming, you don't have to check your facts. You don't have to do anything. Just throw it out. Just believe in whatever you already have. Don't worry about, wait, I left my textbook at home. Let me go back and pick it up. No, don't have to do stuff like that. Don't Google, don't stuff like that. All that is good. But for this particular activity, we want to be fast. We want to be lean. So we want to make sure that you believe whatever is already inside. This is like, you know how when you want to go for exams, the last 5 minutes, it doesn't matter whatever you read, whatever you memorize, it's not going to be there. Have you noticed this? Yeah. Like, you know, I always see this, you know, always Malaysians do this because I went to London, right? So basically in my class, Malaysians, last 5 minutes, right? Whoa, so fast. And in my head, I'm like, dude, if you don't already have it in your head, you're never going to have it now. Unless you can like somehow photocopy in your head. You know what I mean, right? So let's just believe whatever in your brain now is good enough. Okay, so that's the reason I put up there. And this is what we're going to brainstorm. A solution that can affect a million lives in a year from now. That's the reason I picked this. So a while back, Mindvalley did a competition. The competition was actually to come out with a solution that's supposed to affect a million lives in a year from now. I love this question because you have a quantum, a million lives, and you know when you're going to start now. Okay? And the thing is, it's a solution. It's not like a suit of solutions. Right? They just ask for a solution. It's a damn good way to actually start from scratch. Meaning you're not assuming. You're not saying like, come out with a solution that will be inside your handphone that will cost like 20 million to build. Nothing like that. You see, the constraint is good enough that we have 1 million. The impact is there, but it's not constrained that way.